Hello, my fellow critical thinkers. As of lately, two very popular science communicators on YouTube, being Professor Dave and Sabine Hossenfelder, have gotten into some kind of quarrel. Dave accuses Sabine of using negative science rhetoric and damaging science because of it. Sabine, of course, denies this. It started a week ago with a video from Dave, in which he kind of carefully and calmly addressed some problems that he experienced with some of Sabina's videos, and that resulted in a video from Sabina in which she defended her position. Well, the result was that Dave published another long video in which he went kind of berserk on Sabina. To me, this is a difficult topic, because for years I've watched many of the videos of both Dave and Sabina, and I'm very thankful for all the hard work they did for science communication. However, the more I assess the videos of Sabina, the more I understand parts of the problems that Dave has. In his last video, Dave gave a pretty deep analysis of what he thinks is wrong with some of the videos of Sabina, so there's not much that I can add at this point in time. And since I only planned on making a relatively short video today, I will for now only focus on some remarkable metrics of Sabina's recent videos. So, in addition to what Dave did, I analyzed all the thumbnails of the videos that Sabina made for the past 12 months to see how many of her thumbnails I could find that I think would disqualify science in general. Well, I really only found four, and they are: I don't trust scientists, the end of science, is science dying, and most recently, science is failing. That, of course, is bad marketing for science, which is rather odd, coming from someone who we would generally see as a science communicator. On the other hand, that is only four problematic thumbnails during 12 months in which Sabina uploaded 291 videos, so the damage seems to be limited. But I said I would focus on some metrics of her videos. Well, as it seems, the type of video with a thumbnail that disqualifies science in general, these videos seem to perform much better than average on Sabina's channel. I made a chart in which I have summarized some general metrics from Sabina's 10 most recent videos. I noted the number of views and the number of likes, and from that I simply calculated the number of likes per 100 views. Now, the numbers in the green bar are from Sabina's recent video with the thumbnail saying, "Science is failing." Now, that video has about 3 times more views than average, and that probably means more cash for Sabina. Of course, I cannot see into the detailed metrics of this video, but I guess in the science niche, it's not uncommon to make about $3,000 to $4,000 on a video with this kind of view count. So possibly, this science communicator makes $3,000 to $4,000 from a video that is promoted by saying, "Science is failing," which gives me kind of an uneasy feeling. Something else in these metrics is notable. The video with the thumbnail saying "Science is failing" also has the second highest like to views ratio, which means that not only does this video get a lot more views than Sabina's other videos, but the video also seems to reach an audience that likes the message "Science is failing." And that is something that deserves some extra thought. And I wonder what your thoughts are. Let me know in the comments, and thanks for watching.